Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I got the opportunity to interview a mechanical engineer who moved to Canada under the Express Entry program, and he started working in his field of mechanical engineering without having any Canadian education. He got a job based on his experience and his education from India. So in this video, I asked him a few questions about the interview process, what were the steps he took to apply for a job, what was the interview process like, and what are the problems faced by skilled immigrants who move to Canada and want to start working in their own field. So without wasting any time, let's get right into it.
So hi Nishant, welcome to the channel and thank you so much for taking out the time to doing this video.
Hi, pleasure is all mine.
So we can start with a brief introduction about yourself. Can you please let us know, you know, what do you do, what's your educational background and what is your professional experience till now?
Yeah, well, I'm Nishant Vyas. I'm originally from Ahmedabad, Gujarat. And my educational background is mechanical. I have BE from Gujarat Technological University. And then I have a master's from Nirmal University. And my field master's field is computer integrated manufacturing. And then I have 5 year experience in the design engineering field. I was associated with Linomatic Graphic Industries, which is based in Ahmedabad. But I worked over there for around 5 years. And then I moved over here for obviously personal as well as professional growth. And now I'm currently working with a US-based company, which is Baltimore Air Coil Company. And again, as a design engineer.
Okay. So, you know, you were working as a mechanical engineer back home. You have 5 years of experience. You have great education, bachelor's and master's in mechanical. And, you know, once you decide that you want to move to Canada, you became a permanent resident, right? And did you start applying for jobs back, like from back home, or did you, you know, started applying for jobs in your field after you moved over here?
Yeah, well, obviously, I did a research when I started even my process for the PR, but due to COVID, the process got extended by 2 years. So that was a pain from the start. So I thought that once I got my COPR, I'll start my research again. Right.
Okay.
So that if I need any education over there or certification over there to get a job or not. But through looking up or through research, I got an idea that if I show my experience, I might be able to get a job over there without any education over there in Canada. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So I started applying for jobs 1 month before I moved over here. But the major obstruction I faced was that they needed a Canadian contact information, right? Like phone numbers or address. If someone could help you out with that take a phone number for you and just forward it to an Indian number, then that might work. But I thought that let us try without that. And if things work out, then things work out. But I didn't got any reply from any of the companies which I applied from India. But once I came over here and started applying from here with an address over here and contact number, the replies came flying.
Okay. So now you have experience of working as a mechanical engineer, both in India and Canada. So from your point of view, what do you think, like, is there a difference in the field of mechanical engineering in these two countries, or is everything like completely similar?
There is a slight difference. I worked in India for one company for 5 years and then I moved over here. And this is my first working experience over here. So the processes are almost similar. 70-80% things are almost done similarly. But the time savings is a lot because certain things in India are done manually. Whereas over here, they have set up a macros or automatic softwares for certain things. So that saves times, increases productivity. Plus, the workplace is very lenient, very flexible. You can come at a certain time. You can go complete your work, certain related to banks, government document submissions, such as. Whereas back in India, had a very strict schedule to follow, right? Come in at a certain time, leave at a certain time. Before that, you can't leave. If you need, then take a leave or a half day. Nothing, you can't go out without taking a leave, right? So that was a thing I found very useful. Because obviously over here, shops and government offices also closes at the same time as the office time, right? Yeah, so if it's no reason to go after the office hours, yeah.
Okay, so flexibility is one of the main difference and, you know, certain processes are automated, especially in Canada. Yes.
Yeah, and would like to add that the designing processes are similar because the engineering concepts are universal all around the world, right? Universal, right? So if you have basics clear, you won't have any problem coming over, applying it over here. Obviously, you'll need to adjust to certain aspects over here because they'll do certain things or they'll follow certain standards, Canadian standards, right? So in India, safety wasn't a major issue, but over here, they have a major restrictions regarding the safety. So you can't do certain things or design certain things which might hinder human life or human health. So
Yeah, health and safety is always a big concern
yeah.
when you're operating in Canada. Okay. So if you don't mind me asking, like, what was your interview process like over here?
Well, so first of all, the interview I gave over here were my first interview experience because back in India, my academic was enough for me to get into as a trainee engineer in the company. Then they converted me after my master's completed, they converted me to a design engineer, seeing my work and my learning process, right? But over here, I was nervous from the start because I have never given interview before. But from what I have heard from others in India, that our interviews in India are very technical. They don't require that much technical background to do certain things, but they would ask technical questions. And if you don't know, they might reject you based on that. But in actual, you don't require that much information regarding the theory of things, right? Because certain things are done very differently in a practical manner when you come in mechanical field, right? Because you have to see that how things are on hand, right? You have to get your hands dirty and certain things. Similarly, over here, they don't particularly ask for technical questions, right? Technical background, but they would verify that you have a particular type of education. But then they ask you situational questions that what if you face a certain type of problem, what you would do and how you would give a solution to that, right? Because I had a prior experience, they had asked me that if you have faced certain issues while working with other employees, right? So how would you tackle that? Yeah, so and if you require a manager who would always be on focus on you or will stand beside you and just tell you that do things right that way, or you require a manager that would give you work and then won't come to you. If you have an issue, you go to him, and if not, then complete the work and submit to him. Yeah, so certain such type of questions, nothing too technical, right?
And question to you would be like, what is one piece of advice you would like to give to a mechanical engineer, you know, who is working outside of Canada but who has, you know, a wish to move to Canada as a permanent resident? What should they do?
Well, first of all, I'd like to clarify that moving over here as a mechanical engineer with or without an experience is doesn't matter because it's really hard for us. Yeah, so because ours is a major practical field, right? You need hand-to-hand experience with certain things. But if you have a very generalized advice, I could give that if you have experience with a different type of 3D softwares, AutoCAD, Autodesk Inventor, SOLIDWORKS, Solid Edge, and then Creo, and even FEA analysis, which is analysis of structures different types, that is done through ANSYS. If you have that, if not, just get a certification, learn about them, learn the basics, because companies over here require that because they would hire you based on the knowledge of the softwares. And that would create chances to get you hired, get you starting even a basic entry level job, but it would be in the field, so that would be really helpful, right? So once you are in, you'll climb up the ladder in no time.
So certifications can be very, very helpful
Very,
in the,
very helpful.
especially in the field of mechanical engineering, right? And having knowledge about different softwares. So now let's talk about, you know, registration as an engineer in Canada, how, you know, hard it is or how different it is for a mechanical engineer to migrate over here and get registered as an engineer. Because, you know, if you get registered as an engineer, let's say an EIT or a PEng, obviously you will get better opportunities, better pay, better, you know, career prospects. So what is your view on that?
Well, I personally want to get registered as a PEng, and I've started doing research on that also. because salary difference is a huge plus living in Canada. And I've heard that my previous experience in the field might get counted, but they need a certain paperwork or two from the company which I work with. I don't exactly know. So I'm trying to get in contact with the PNG office over here, but it's really helpful if you are a PNG because you can get a job all around the Canada. But the problem is that each and every province has a different type of process for PNG. So that is a side issue that I faced because I had research in Calgary. They had a certain different process over there. I had an offer from Vancouver regarding design engineering, so I had researched over there, and now I'm researching over here. All three different processes.
Yes.
But once you have a PNG, you can convert it to each and every province. That is easy,
Easier.
easy. Yeah, it's easier. Just like license, you can convert it from each province to each. But the processes are different. So currently, I'm in process of getting PNG myself. But if I wouldn't have a, if they won't count my experience in India, then I'll have to start from EIT and then work under a PNG manager for a couple of years, 3 4 years, and then they might give me a PNG.
Can you please let us know of all the countries that you can possibly go? Why did you choose to come to Canada?
Choosing Canada was a very personal reason for me because back in India it was too much chaos, too much chaotic for my own self. So I've heard that the life over here, obviously it is hard for students when they move over here, but after that, after certain years, you when you settle down over here, it's very peaceful. And so that was the major reason for me. And again, then the professional growth, because I had a background in design engineering. So I thought that obviously design engineering over here would be different, but obviously with my experience back in India, I'll be easy to get up to the speed with the standards over here and everything.
So you are currently living in Prince Edward Island and working as a design engineer in that province, right? Why specifically Prince Edward Island? Because normally when people move to Canada, that's what I have noticed, that people normally go for Toronto or Calgary or Vancouver. So why Prince Edward Island?
Well, originally I landed in Calgary
Okay.
starting out. Yeah, so I have a friend over there. He had a house, so it was easy for me to move over there. And then I started to apply. And so the major reason I have moved over here is my job, because it required me to visit the office for a couple of days. I have a hybrid setup, so I can work from home also, but they need me in the PEI region. So that is the main reason I moved over here. I had an offer from Vancouver also, similar, but it was a contract, so I didn't opted for that. I wanted a full-time option for my first job over here. Yeah.
And now let's talk about Prince Edward Island. Like, you have been living there for some time now. Like, how good is the province? Or how good is the weather? If you can share a few places that people can visit when they're in Prince Edward Island.
I came over here in October, so kind of starting of winter. So I myself haven't visited much of over here, but I have heard from others that the roommates I live with that there are huge amount of beaches over here, and they are beautiful. The summer is beautiful over here because the weather over here is windy. It's December and it hasn't snowed over here yet. All over Canada it has snowed, but it hasn't over here. It's raining outside right now. It's around 10, 12 degrees. Obviously, it's windy, so you feel around -2, -3. But yeah, and they have various universities as well as college over here. So a student culture over here. They have different communities, Punjabi communities, Gujarati. So I currently I'm Gujarati, so I'm currently living with a Gujarati community. We have a group of around 30, 40 people. We are planning to visit a nearby cottage. We have rented a cottage, and we are planning on the Christmas weekend. We are planning to go over there, and then after that, in summer, we are planning other things on the beach because so summer is a time when you go
You
out
make a
and
lot of
enjoy.
plans.
Yeah.
So it is easy to find like-minded people in Prince Edward Island, right? Well, we can find
Yeah,
the
yeah.
communities because there are different communities living there right now.
Yeah, a lot of different type of communities you find.
Okay. Yeah. So that's all the questions I have, Nishant. Again, thank you so much for your time. And I'm sure your overview and your piece of advice that you have given throughout this interview will be very helpful for people who want to migrate to Canada and who are in the field of mechanical engineering. Thanks again.
Yeah, no problem. Happy to help.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. And for more videos like this, stay updated by subscribing to this channel and share this video with other friends as well. Till the next video, take care. Bye-bye.